practically standing still now. They've dropped ropes out of the nose of the ship, and it's been taken a hold up down on the field by a number of men. The back motors of the ship are just holding it just enough to keep it from... It burst into flames.
Wait, get this started. It's crashing terrible. Oh, my, get out of the way, please. It's burning, bursting into flames, and it's falling on the mooring fast, and all the folks will see that this is terrible. This is the worst of the worst catastrophes in the world. Four or 500 feet into the sky, it's a terrific crash, ladies and gentlemen. The smoke and the flames now, and the frame is crashing to the ground, not quite to the mooring mast. All the humanity and all the passengers screaming around me. I told you, I can't even talk to people and friends are out there. I can't talk, ladies and gentlemen.
The Hindenburg. It is still one of the two biggest airships ever built. Here you can see the Hindenburg was as big as the Titanic and three Boeing 747s. So it was 246.7 meters long, and its biggest diameter was 41.2 meters. It mostly weighed 215 tons. Of these, 118 tons was the weight of the construction. The Hindenburg contained 88,000 liters of diesel fuel, 4.5 thousand liters of lubricating oil, and 40 thousand liters of water ballast. They used four Daimler-Benz diesel engines, which were placed in four cabins which were hanging from the ship. Because of these, the Hindenburg made 125 kilometers per hour. The Hindenburg flew because of 190,000 cubic meters of hydrogen. The Germans wanted to use helium for the Hindenburg, but the US didn't want to sell some of theirs, so the Germans had to build the Hindenburg with hydrogen, which is highly explosive. It was built over 5 years and finished at 4th of March 1936. The passengers had 2 decks to sleep, eat and stay in. From the lower deck, you were able to look through windows right down to the ground. The Hindenburg had got 54 beds for the crew and 72 beds for passengers, but the cabins weren't used all the time because they were really sparse. The passengers mostly were in the lounges to eat and to look outside. Every cabin had a sink with warm and cold water, which you were able to lift up after use. Toilets weren't in the cabins. Thousand passengers had to go to the lower deck if they wanted to use one. Even if fire is dangerous in a hydrogen-using airship, they had a smoker's lounge where the only cigarette lighter on board was in. The design of the furniture was by Fritz August Breuhaus de Groot, and they also had a special piano. It was from Blüthner, which still produced pianos, and was extra light, 180 kg, because of using aluminium. It was removed because they wanted to make the Hindenburg lighter. In 1943, it had been destroyed while a bombing. If you're blue and you don't know where to go to, why don't you go where fashion sits? LZ-129 Hindenburg was a large commercial passenger carrying rigid airship named after the late Field Marshal Paul von Hindenburg, who lived from 1847 to 1934 and who was the president of Germany from 1925 to 1934. It was one of the biggest symbols of power for the Nazis, because it was the biggest rigid airship of the world. The swastikas on the tail show also said the Hindenburg was a symbol for the Nazis. The Hindenburg was the fastest possibility to travel from Europe to both American continents, and could transport a lot of people and goods. The first commercial passenger flight was a 4-day transatlantic voyage to Rio de Janeiro that departed from the Friedrichshafen airport and took place on 31st of March 1936. This was the beginning of a new commercial era of passenger and goods transportation. Snappy, you'll declare it's simply topping to be there and hear them swapping smart tidbits. Put on the Ritz. The Deutsche Zeppelin Reederei, the owner of the Hindenburg, hoped for many passengers in the second transatlantic season of the Hindenburg. Because King George's coronation was forthcoming, so the Zeppelin Reederei added new rooms on the airship. But of the 72 possible passengers, only 36 passengers were on board. Many people feared of bomb attacks. The journey was normally and boringly. The passengers wanted several weather. At the end of the traveling, the Hindenburg was in front of a thunderstorm. The captain of the Hindenburg aerated and circumnavigated the thunderstorm. But the material of the airship changed electrostatically and the ship exploded. The hydrogen burned from the stern to the peak. The fire flashed like the daylight. Spectators brought themselves down. People went burning out of the fire. The wreck engulfed people who rescued themselves. 36 persons died. This was the first big German Zeppelin disaster.